Hello, I'm Florence the Machine. I'm in a park, and I can safely say that the squirrels and pigeons are terrifying, but I found a stick to beat them away. I might also use it as a drumstick, but I haven't decided yet.
I look weird. Like, what are this chair is doing?
Hi.
Yeah. Yo, we got some wine up in here, everybody.
My real surname.
Not the and the machine.
I changed it by deed poll to and the machine. It's now my real surname.
It's a lie.
That is a lie. My real surname. Well, my full name is. I think we're supposed to keep it hidden for like. But my full name here is here's the exclusive. Florence Leontine Mary Welch.
Wow. Better than And the Machine.
Do you think I should change my band name to Florence Leontine Mary Welch instead of And
nice.
The Machine?
Everyone seems to be going for things like Adele, Duffy.
Yeah.
For the full name.
Have the whole thing. I grew up in London, really near a mental hospital, which says a lot.
This is my room. I've just got the most amount of stuff, just piles and piles and piles that just keep disappearing.
When you were young, you wanted to be?
A zoologist. I also wanted to be a secretary, weirdly, because I thought it was like really glamorous, you know, you like had a Diet Coke for lunch.
You strike me as somebody who maybe not only had an imaginary friend as a childhood, but maybe had an imaginary world.
Well, I remember I got really obsessed with Little House on the Prairie, so me and my sister, we had a bunk bed, and so we made the bunk bed into the house and the whole rest of the room into the prairie with like a towel river and like fields of corn made of books, and it was really boring actually because the only game was go out, plow, come home, cook in the house, fish in the towel river.
When I was in school, I was just always hiding in the library, like skiving off my lessons, but in the library, like not doing anything cool, just like reading.
I do have a really weird memory of being at school and singing hymns, and the kids in like the row in front of me looking behind like. Because I don't know, I must have been singing it really loudly.
Can you read music?
Kind of.
Do you want to elaborate on?
Well, I did music theory and like, but I only got like to the really tough bit. I only got to grade 4, and then the really tough bit starts at grade 5, and I didn't practice enough, so I stopped. But yeah, I haven't got grade 5 singing theory. No, that is my deep, deep shame. Shouldn't really be here. Should go home.
Gotta do something professional!
Like, oh, gotta go get tattoos! And went to the Black Cat tattoo parlour. And I got it done by this amazing, massive Texan called Animal. But it was his last tattoo of the night, and he's like, I'm gonna take my time with this one. I'm gonna put a lot of love into it, okay? It's like, okay, Animal.
I can do like this kind of accent. I think, like, sort of, Coney Island fairground, and like, I just cut my nails.
Just like all these strangers just staring at like this ancient creature that was dead, and no one could figure out what it was until some guy jogged past and went, that's an alligator turtle. Their heads can't retract.
I can see a Vampire Weekend in the background.
Yes, they're starting. We're going to wrap up very soon.
I'll see ya. Hey. It's a really amazing impression.
I'll see ya. They were actually playing when. No, you were playing when we interviewed them, so this is.
Oh, really? Were they doing a bad impression of me?
Well, we're going to wait.
Maybe like this.
Singing loudly, out of tune.
I got very, very, very starstruck when Alicia Keys walked in to the catering area, and I was sitting down, and I looked up and I was like, oh my God, it's Alicia Keys. And I could see her security guard behind her, like, looking at me, like, going, she's the one. She's going to be the weird one. Alpha Tango Bravo. Hi, welcome to Camden. It's no longer on fire, but Amy Winehouse has gone missing. Yeah, I like all kinds of stuff. Scented candles.
Purple bicycles.
Yeah, loads of stuff.
Excellent.
You could get me a scented purple bicycle that's on fire.
Hey, look, that's my mission. I'll meet you back here next year and I'll have a scented purple bicycle for you.
Why is that flaming bicycle coming towards me? Oh, it's okay. It smells like
patchouli. I told you.
What's the most ridiculous rumour you've ever heard about yourself?
I think there's a lot of confusion as to how tall I am. I think that, well, I'm this tall, but this is with heels,
So I think I'm actually about this tall, which isn't, and I think everyone kind of expects me to come in and be like 7 foot tall. And I always feel really bad for people because I walk in, I'm kind of regular height, not wearing bat wings. I think everyone does expect me to be like riding in on a chariot, holding a sword, 7 feet tall, screaming. And it's just, I think they're disappointed when I walk in.
My other fact that I came across, you have a crippling fear of technology.
Crippling fear?
Yeah.
I'm not like afraid of my phone.
Okay.
Every time it rings, ah!
Then what really scares me is like the whole comments thing. Because I mean, even if it's like a really cute like puppy on YouTube, you can have someone that's going, it's the ugliest puppy I've ever seen.
What is your favourite monster? And what is your favourite bird? And what is your favourite kind of moon? You know, like you can have a full moon, a crescent moon, new moon.
Are you a believer in werewolves?
I don't know, I've yet to meet one, but if any are out there,
get in touch.
Get in touch.
My boyfriend was actually building a coffin and couldn't take me on a date, so I was upset. Well, you know, it's your first boyfriend, and it's all like, oh, you're not going to take me on a date. Oh, you're building a coffin. What is this?
I was having these like anxiety dreams where I turned up at the Brits and I was running backwards down the wrong way in the paparazzi in my pajamas, going, no, don't look at me.
I do some really, really strange running because I get really, because I like to. I can't really go to the gym because I can't like run in an enclosed space. I have to feel like I'm like running through like fields. So if I go to the local park, but I always end up like jumping on the benches and sort of trying to two-step, balletic running. But it's not very balletic. It's more sort of, who's that strange girl doing a gangly dance in the middle of the park?
This is such a surreal day. I don't feel like I'm a real person.
It all got quite surreal. So, hence the hat.
Put this down. It's quite heavy. Could you mind if I put this down? Because it's quite heavy. I'll just put it there.
On the stage today, I had this beautiful ornamental flower on here, and it got stuck on my dress. It was like, freedom! Freedom!
Yeah.
Do you sit in your room listening to dance music, turning the lights on and off with the beat?
No.
Making your own strobe light? Is that how it all began?
I'm up there. They've got rabies, all of them! Oh my god, someone get me an injection!
I don't feel like.
Yeah, I think, oh my god, I just saw this massive spider. It's just there. Oh, hello, little guy. He's just waiting. He's like, he can hear me, he stopped.
Wow, I've just realised every single person who I've seen on the red carpet who's come for the Mercury's is wearing black.
What is that?
Oh, what does it mean?
We're all coming to our own funeral.
The world's got a funny colour.
Are you seeing, the whole world's gone green. Does anyone else see that?
I feel like we're on one of those shopping channels.
Is that bad? I mean, you don't want to talk about the same old. Why did you write that one song, dude?
I have a contract with Estee Lauder.
Well, you will after this, and I'll get about 30%. Estee Lauder, will you sign this beautiful woman talented up, please?
It also looks good on her, on men.
Would you like it to put on my body? Oh, go ahead.
Oh, gosh.
Uh-huh. See, it suits everybody.
When I was a child, I have thrown batteries as hard as possible to try to get them to explode.
Yeah, I used to like try and like set batteries on fire. Yeah. I always thought that you would open it and like this weird like liquid like.
Yeah, or the future
out.
Was inside.
Yeah, the future. Ah, oh, I can see the future.
When I'm at home and I need to relax, just whack out a strobe light, watch myself doing things in a funny slow motion.
I think that's exactly the same.
I know. I would totally wear this.
I just collect things that I already have.
So many red lipsticks that you collect?
I'm in a lot of airports, and right. It's just kind of like a weird, weird like OCD thing. Even though I've got so many, I'm just like, ooh, this is like a tiny bit different from the other one I have.
Right.
And the packaging is pretty. Okay. And you know, it's like one of those things that you can, because it's not big, it's not that expensive. The little luxuries, I think, are the things that keep you going.
I've got this little keyboard player who's actually about the size of a Ford, like a 12-year-old child. And so she has one beer and she's like, because her body capacity is like this much for alcohol.
It's my dad drunk
Right, he'd come see me at a gig, and then it was outside, and he was like, "Darling, I am fine. I can ride my bicycle all the way back to Camberwell, which is in South London." I was like, "Dad, you cannot ride your bicycle home. You just can't." And he's like, "Yes, I can. Just watch me go." I was like, "Okay, we'll give you a trial run." He got on the bike. I was like, "Look, if you can cycle to the end of this road, then you can go home on your bike." Of course I can. He got on the bike, literally got like a yard. Flat out.
Was your dad a tour manager at one point for you?
In his camper van. Yeah. Well, we didn't have any money. And then we got offered to support MGMT around Europe. And MGMT were like driving through Europe in this big American tour bus. Like, and we'd spot the venue because we'd be like, oh, there it is. Right. And we would literally, it was ridiculous. We'd turn up like there were pots and pans clanking and I'm hanging out the window. I'm like, hello, we're here. But we did all have to sit at the front of the camper van while going up big hills because we were worried that it wouldn't make it. Well, my dad's Justin Bieber's tour manager now.
Yeah, he's doing well.
Oh my God, and we got, and to the people who own, to the camper van people, we are not going on tour, we're going on a cultural retreat. That's, yes, a quiet holiday, a quiet holiday. Stick to that. I can't really get used to it. I just go where they tell me to go. Go here, sing, okay. Talk to this person, okay. Have this phone. It's fun, I like it. I have other people that tell me where to go. I don't have to make any of my own decisions. This is what I like, because that gives me more time to do this. I think that's about it. I don't know what else to say. I think that's covered all the bases. Covered all the bases. The basis of Florence and the Machine is covered. It's been nice to be on your television. Goodbye. Oh, it's just the most beautiful day!